The Philadelphia 76ers can't buy good press. They're like the NBA equivalent of the Dallas Cowboys in the NFL. They have polarizing star players, bad management in the front office, the perception that there's always some type of issue going on in the locker room, or an issue between a star player and a member of management. Think about the Sixers since the Allen Iverson era. They had a little bit of success with Andre Iguodala. It wasn't really a memorable era, but I liked the tandem of Iguodala and a young Drew Holiday. The Sixers blew that up and went straight into the process. And after years of painfully unwatchable basketball, the process worked. It eventually gifted the Sixers with two superstar players in Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons. After receiving that gift from the basketball gods, a gift that most NBA teams would love to unwrap, talk is once again emerging about splitting up Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons. It's a topic of conversation all week on these national talk shows. You check Twitter. There are some fans in Philadelphia that are talking about what they could get if they traded one or both of their stars. I'll be honest with you guys. I used to be in the same camp of splitting up this duo. I used to think that Embiid and Simmons couldn't coexist, couldn't work together. Their relationship has been somewhat volatile at times, so it's understandable why people think that way. But I have changed my stance on this. A lot has changed in the past several months. If I remember correctly, I posted a video supporting splitting up these guys back in February or March. But like I said, I've changed my mind. Now, I think it would be a mistake for Philadelphia to split up their two young superstar players. Before I tell you why, let me say this. I understand why people are pushing this idea of splitting up Embiid and Simmons. Their perception is that they just don't fit well together. Ben Simmons is not your typical point guard. They play two completely different styles of basketball. Simmons is more effective in transition and a fast-paced offense, and Joel Embiid is an old-school type of post-up player. I understand why this idea has come up again. Embiid has been thriving in Orlando, and now, with Ben Simmons seemingly out for the playoffs, we are going to see what Embiid and the Sixers can do without him. Now, have the 76ers been a disappointment this season? Of course they have. They're worse than they were last year. Going into this season, the Sixers were thought to be the team that would actually challenge Milwaukee for the Eastern Conference. Their general manager, Elton Brand, actually made moves in the offseason to bolster the defense, so when Joel Embiid is on the bench, there's not a drastic free fall on the defensive end of the floor. The idea was to cater this roster to be able to defend against Giannis and hopefully take the Eastern Conference from the Bucks. That's why they brought in Al Horford. How has this idea, how has that worked out for Philadelphia? I think it's been a disaster. No one is talking about the Sixers being a threat in the Eastern Conference. In three games against Milwaukee this season, they're 1-2, and the two losses have come by an average of 16 points, so they're not even close. Giannis is averaging 28 points a game. Against the top teams in the Eastern Conference, Milwaukee, Toronto, Miami, Boston, Philadelphia is 6-9 in those games. There's not a Ben Simmons, Joel Embiid problem in Philadelphia. There is a management problem in Philadelphia. The 6 years that Embiid has been with the Sixers, they have been through five general managers. Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons didn't let J.J. Redick and Jimmy Butler walk. Elton Brand did, as well as a difference with Brett Brown in the case of Jimmy Butler. The loss of both of those guys has been devastating for the Sixers offensively. They went from 8th to 15th in offensive rating, scoring 5 points less every game. That's what happens when you lose a combined 36 points per game with the loss of Redick and Butler. Now, sure, the Sixers have improved a bit defensively, but it has cost them. I always say that defense wins championships, and that's true in the NBA. But in a three-point shooting league, you got to be able to put up some points, too. And the Sixers let two of their three-point shooters walk. Plus, Butler was running the offense at times, especially in the playoffs last year. Like I said earlier, this is not a Joel Embiid, Ben Simmons problem. What would happen in Philadelphia if they traded Joel Embiid? You would lose your defensive anchor. Al Horford cannot replace his presence defensively. Not to mention the fact that Al Horford's not just getting old. He's already there. He's already old. This contract is likely the last one of his NBA career. And good for him that he got $109 million, but the Sixers vastly overpaid him. And if you trade Ben Simmons, your team would be solely reliant on Joel Embiid, which wouldn't be a big deal if he could stay healthy. Embiid has missed 284 games in 6 years. That's damn near 482-game seasons. Now, granted, he has been healthier the last 3 years compared to his first couple in the league, but he still never played anywhere near a full 82-game season. So would you be willing to trade Ben Simmons and rely solely on Joel Embiid? I wouldn't. When you have two superstars like this on one team, you find a way to make it work, and Brett Brown has failed to do so. It wouldn't surprise me if he was gone at the end of this season. Joel Embiid has actually come to the defense of Ben Simmons, claiming that all of these rumors of strife between them are just lies. And to Ben Simmons' credit, I know he gets flack sometimes for his defense, but he's a really good defender when he's focused. Game 7 last year against Toronto, he stuffed Kawhi Leonard, held him to 2 of 11 when he was guarding him. But the problem was, no one else on the roster could stop Kawhi. He shot 50% against the rest of the team. Anyway, you've got to give Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons some time here to develop. I mean, people forget, they've really only been together for 3 years. They only have two playoff runs together. That is not a lot of time in the NBA to develop a championship-level team. Championship teams take years to develop, years to get there. I always reference Michael Jordan when talking about this, but it's a great example. Took Jordan and the Bulls several years of playing and losing together before they became a championship team. Same thing with the Golden State Warriors. If Philadelphia decided to trade Ben Simmons or Joel Embiid, they would be worse than they are now. You will never get equal value back in return. Anytime we see teams trade superstar players, the team that is trading them rarely gets better. In 99% of cases, they get worse, a lot worse. Everyone, myself included, considered the Anthony Davis trade last summer to be a huge success for the Pelicans. And it was. New Orleans got younger. They received a good core group of young players to complement Zion Williamson. It made sense. I mean, Anthony Davis wanted out, so they got as much as they could get in return. But Lonzo Ball, Josh Hart, Brandon Ingram combined, they aren't close to the player that Anthony Davis is. And as a result, the Lakers became an instant championship contender, and the Pelicans are out of the playoff picture. What about when Oklahoma City traded James Harden back in 2012, right after they had made the NBA Finals? They still had Kevin Durant and Russell Westbrook on the roster. Does anyone even remember who Oklahoma City got in return for James Harden? Jeremy Lamb, Kevin Martin, plus some draft picks. Clearly, Houston won that trade. Even with KD and Westbrook on the team, the Thunder never made it back to the NBA Finals without James Harden. The bottom line is, you don't trade superstar-level players. The only time you do is when they are forcing your hand and they want out. And neither Joel Embiid or Ben Simmons are doing that. Like I said a second ago, Joel Embiid is actually defending their pairing. He has defended it on multiple occasions. Said he wants to play with Ben Simmons his entire career. The Sixers, what they need is perimeter players, wing players. They need three-point shooters. Honestly, they need to get rid of everyone around Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons and rebuild this team to complement them. But it's kind of hard to do that when you have two untradeable contracts with Al Horford and Tobias Harris. I like Tobias Harris. Think he's a good player. Good role player. But Elton Brand is paying him like he is a superstar player. He gave Tobias Harris Jimmy Butler, LeBron James, Anthony Davis type money. Elton Brand was the only executive in the NBA that thought Tobias Harris was worth $35+ million a year. Philadelphia has a front office problem. They have a coaching problem. Instead of contemplating trading Simmons or Embiid, they need to be thinking about who to hire as general manager and head coach. Get two people in there that have the ability to build a supporting cast around their two superstars, not think about trading them. All right, that's all for today. Make sure to hit that like and subscribe button for me. Click the notification bell to receive all notifications from the channel. Leave me a comment in the section below. Do you think the Sixers should trade Joel Embiid or Ben Simmons? Or maybe you think that they should trade them both? Let me know your thoughts. You can follow me on Twitter at KC_BTL84. If you have any questions or topic you'd like me to discuss, you can email me at btlkc84@gmail.com. Enjoy your weekend. I'll see you guys next time.